ज्ञानानन्दमयं देवं निर्मलस्फटिकाकृतिं आधारं सर्वविद्यानां हयग्रीवमुपास्महे। नमस्ते। डियर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स ऑफ यूनिवर्स, संगे शक्ति कलियुगे, यूनिटी इज द पावर ऑफ कलियुग। टाइम हैज कम टू कम दैट ऑल हिंदूज ऑफ यूनिवर्स हैज टू कम टुगेदर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट रोल ऑफ प्रीस्ट्स, द फ्यूचर ऑफ हिंदू सोसाइटी, चैलेंजेस एंड रिस्पॉन्सेस abroad, especially in USA. First topic is role of a Hindu priest. The best way to preserve and promote Vedic Hindu Dharma is through the Hindu temples. The well-trained Hindu priests are the key to accomplish this goal. They enlighten the devotees with their devotion towards God and with his rituals that he performs to the God. He brings all devotees together and he tries to give them peace of mind during the prayers. And also he conducts all kind of rituals, religious ceremonies at temple as well as at their homes for all the priests, for the Hindu devotees that who is migrated to United States of America. Lot of them, they are all born and brought up here, and in their busy schedule they could not learn about Hinduism, and in abroad they are all very interested to learn Hinduism and practice our Hindu rituals, and also they want to learn, and also they want to give it to their kids for the future to take over our Hindu religion in abroad. So with that, we try to help them to explain about all the rituals, that what we are doing, why. If you take wedding, for example. So most of the weddings are happening between interfaith marriages in America. So it's a big challenge that today we are facing, that most of the kids are getting married with other religion. So during this time, parents wanted to have a wedding with a Hindu tradition. And the boy and girl who is coming from other religion, they wanted to have their wedding in their own religion. So here is the problem, that they come to us and they will ask that we wanted to have a Hindu wedding, and they want both. So, and also they wanted to have in a short way that can fit. Usually in India we do weddings for 3-4 days, but in there they wanted to have it a wedding in only 1 hour. So it's very problem to us that we have to condense all these rituals without affecting the main purpose of the Hindu Shastras, and we try to accommodate that kind of the weddings, and also we try to explain all the religious significance of the each step. Priest is the one who has the peace with himself, master of all his senses, and compassionate to other living beings. So since as a priest, you know, he will have all these nitya karmas that he has to perform. With that shakti, you know, he will have a peace on himself. And also he will try to guide all the devotees to go in a right path. The Hindu worship services called puja Literally, adoration is the central activity in the most temples conducted by a priest. Each temple will have its priest or even a whole team who perform regular worship in the temples. Hindu priests conduct special ceremonies such as various rites of passage both in the temple and people's homes. Hindu priests conduct rites such as marriages, home purification, naming ceremonies, and organize regular festivals. Priests offer help to the sick, dying at beaver at the offer counseling to couples who are getting married. And also sometimes we go to the hospitals, you know, sometimes hospital calls that a Hindu patient is here and they need a blessings for the patient. So we go to the hospitals and we do the Mrityunjaya Japa and we bless the, we pray to the God to cure this patient soon. And also people come with the, another problem is to divorce. So people, all these couples, newly wedded couple or older wedded couple, you know, they come for this divorce things also. When they come that kind of situations, so we suggest and we emphasize our Hindu values that how our Ekapatni Vrata system has been adopted in our Hinduism for a long time, and that is the way to be live. So most of the, sometimes we succeed, we succeeded with this divorce cases that people did came back without going to the court and they settled out. And also sometimes we have problems with the like a already married man, so he has a divorced wife and also he got second married and their first wife's kid is getting married. So they wanted to have a wedding for their previous wife's son or daughter is getting married. And they say that why we wanted to, how we can do it. No, her mother is divorced or his mother is divorced. And we suggest that, you know, in our Hinduism, we do not have any divorces. Our Shastras did not say anything. We have only for the unite, for the wedding only, we have all the mantras. But we do not have anything for the divorce. But we emphasize that for one person, only one marriage. So we always, whoever has the, given the birth, she or he is the person who can perform the rituals of that wedding. And also here we try to involve all the Hindu community in all the ceremonies without caste and creed. For example, in last year in our temple, we did a 108 Homakunda Vishnu Sahasranama Yajna. So that can, most of the devotees know Vishnu Sahasranama Stotram. Who doesn't know, no, we tried to teach them and we did a Vishnu Sahasranama Yajna with in 108 Homakundas. So here we allowed each and every devotee can come and sit in a Homakunda and they can perform the Homa along chanting with the Vishnu Sahasranama Stotram. So that this gives more participatory thing for all the devotees that and also for the young generation to participate in these pujas. And also we try to maintain our traditions also, our ancient traditions that what we have been following for a long time, to maintain all the traditions and also to accommodate this kind of new request that we did not have any need in Bharat. So there we have to accommodate some kind of special requests that comes from the community. Within the temple, we try to practice only our Hindu activities only. So if somebody wanted to come and marry in our temple in a Christian style or any other religion, we do not allow. So we only do Hindu weddings or Hindu ceremonies in our temple premises. Whereas in hotels, you know, they can have both weddings, but in our Hindu temples, we only have a Hindu ceremonies. And also here, the first generation of Hindus are born and brought up in Bharat, and they migrated to abroad, and there they have built all these temples. As other speakers said this morning, this is a challenge now, how second generation is going to take care of our Hindu temples in abroad. Though first generation Hindus has a very good faith, and also they born in this Karma Bhumi, Bharat, they came there, and their kids are also, all their kids are born and brought up there, and they are more exposed to the other culture outside, because in a day they spend more than 8 to 10 hours outside with other kids and other activities. Those spend with the parents, they can spend 2 hours or 3 hours a day, sometimes lesser than that. That's all they can spend with the parents. So during that time, you know, they will take a meal or a coffee or things like that, watching TV, but they will not have enough time to talk with each other. To accommodate all these problems, that all Hindu temples in America is conducting a Sunday school, Hindu school classes, who is born and brought up in America, all the kids will come and they will learn about Hindu Shastras like Mahabharata and Ramayana stories, and also about our Hindu great leaders, about our Hinduism. All Hindu temple schools are teaching this good Hinduism for our next generation kids. And also, I have observed that if you are born in Bharat and you brought up anywhere in the world, you will have that samskar, and you will automatically, that samskar will show up, that when you see a Guruji or when you go to a temple, how you bow and how you act in the temple, that will be different the kids who is born in abroad. They will not have that kind of attitude and samskar, that how to respond to this kind of religious things. Lack of exposing to the religion, that the significance of rituals and pujas need to be explained. And also, when we went to the Pathshala in India, we do not have, other than mantras, we do not learn any other languages like English or anything. So that's a very important thing, that here in Bharat, all the Pathshalas has to start teaching teaching the meanings of all the mantras, as well as other national or international language like English for the priests. So that way they can explore, they can maintain more Hinduism there in abroad. And also in America, in all the Hindu temples are trying to teach for priests English, some temples. And also nowadays we got all these gadgets like iPods and computers. We use all that for the all pujas, and we download all the mantras in that, and also all the meanings for the mantras. And when we go to the homes and we show it to them, and we try to explain, we give the iPad to the kids so they can read what's there. So, and they will also learn about all the rituals. Challenges, and there is some challenges, attitude, faith and feeling behind performing pujas with younger generation priests. Self-discipline, earning respect and respecting others, that's also one. Should perform Nitya Karmas and respect fellow priests who may come from different traditions. influence of other religions and their culture. Involve balancing India's regional differences. In India, a priest comes from a one part, one region. He will know only that region's traditions. Whereas in America, devotees are coming from all parts of India. So we need to have a broader ideas and broader knowledge about different traditions that we can accommodate to all the devotees, different parts of the country. So I'm going to, here we have some challenges that same-sex marriages, and we have to think about that. And also gender role, sometimes male and female gender roles, maintaining sanctity and cleanliness, all these things we have to discuss in future. I got some photographs that we could not find our presentation in the computer. So this is like participatory pujas for all the devotees. And this is an interfaith wedding. And also this is Sunday schools that we conduct in Hindu mandirs in America. Thank you. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.